under prohibition.
They could see that the prohibition of alcohol caused the emergence of gangsters in the underworld that took control of these substances. Alcohol then was no longer in their control.
Could this be the same for marijuana?
It strengthens organized crime, without a doubt, because you have to be a criminal to sell it. It's that simple.
This brings crime into it. That's why this, the benefits and the ability to make money is so huge in it.
Weapons were used to intimidate people, and we seized approximately 50 weapons, sawed-off shotguns, and most of them are loaded.
Where's all this competition we've heard so much about? You call these prices low?
Marijuana is just a weed. Marijuana is worth more ounce for ounce than gold.
You don't find illegal commodities, you know, at $200 an ounce. You don't even find them at $200 a pound. Heck, most things are $200 a ton for corn and grain and barley. And
that's why when you walk 10 pounds of marijuana across the border into the United States, it becomes worth 20 pounds.
You create an artificially inflated value for that drug that is so huge that people decide it's worth murdering people in order to control this market.
I think the Fraser Institute called cannabis prohibition a gift of revenue to organized crime. But what do growers and dealers think of this?
Would you like to see the government in the future legalize marijuana here?
Stealing money from us?
I know I wouldn't like to see it legalized. The government would control and regulate the product, and that could potentially hurt a lot of people in the industry.
How can you compete with factories? Perfectly rolled out doobies. They perfect it, and we'd all be out of money.
It makes for strange bedfellows. You got the police and the high-level drug dealers both agreeing that we should maintain this prohibition. But when you got high-level drug dealers saying prohibition is good, you might want to scratch your head a little and think, well, shoot, why would they want to continue prohibition?
I can't imagine why a grower who's making $150,000 or $300,000 a year would ever want to see marijuana legalized. I mean, the last thing a grower wants is sensible policy. The madness continues and they continue to get rich.
You know, Betty, I'm going to bring this up at the business meeting tomorrow.
You make the penalty stiffer? You know what? Good. For those people who are not getting caught, price goes up.
See, so not only do we allow them to tell us how much drugs are going to be supplied, potency of those drugs, who they're going to sell to, where they're going to sell them, just to make sure they get it all right, we let them keep all the profits.
So you've got essentially a wild west. You've got an unregulated market in which anything can happen.
It certainly may work for things that people generally accept, but if you try to prohibit something that's in demand, that the people want, then it's pure folly.